And with that, let's get you out to Mercedes-Benz Stadium downtown in the ATL. Standing by is our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. A few moments ago, it was Desmond Trufant of the Falcons making their way out of the tunnel to the delight of this sold-out crowd as his guys get set to do battle with the Green Bay Packers. And hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you take a look at our matchup here. You've got to believe that this is a game that might be won in the trenches.
Oh, without question. This is big person on big person, big unit against big unit.
Meat on meat.
Oh, you got it all. Pick your cliche, but we know this. The ground's going to shake, things are going to rumble, and they're going to have an impact on today's game.
The veteran kicker Mason Crosby set to do the honors here. Charles and I have been looking forward to this one all week. On the return, here's Justin Hardy. He'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. They'll be led out by the reigning MVP of the National Football League in his 10th season now is Matt Ryan.
Been fortunate enough to watch Matt Ryan play ever since he entered the NFL and even dating back to college, and always had the reputation as a gym rat, a guy who would study film morning, noon, and night. But I saw his athleticism get expanded in 2016, able to use his legs to pick up first downs, to keep plays alive, and increase the opportunities to move the ball downfield. He did that quite well.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Down with Ryan. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It's a gain of 5, and that'll make it second down. All right, let's look at the offense. Devontae Freeman, this is a guy that you wanted to talk about, so take it away.
Brandon, have you seen a running back play with such joy as well as such fury? I love the way he runs the football and attacks defenses.
Second down, here's Ryan. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
I like how they work the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
This is Freeman on first and 10. Got a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
The play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan looking deep, and the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, 40 yards, and the Falcons have taken the early lead. Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that that was part of their script, because so many teams script their opening possessions. And whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be one in there where they call a shot play. Go for the big one, and they got it done.
Now Matt Bryant on for the point after. It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. 5 plays there on that drive, and the Falcons score to cap it off. Here's Bosher to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field. You get a look at the Pro Bowl quarterback in his 13th season now out of Cal, Aaron Rodgers.
He led the NFL with 40 touchdown passes in 2016. In fact, he's only the 4th quarterback to throw at least 40 touchdowns in multiple seasons. And he keeps getting better. Better timing, better understanding of the offensive system, and great coordination with his play-calling head coach.
Rodgers gonna throw. And he completes it to Jordy Nelson. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now the first carry for Ty Montgomery. And a solid run down inside the 30. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
I think many people thought Ty Montgomery would automatically go back to being a wide receiver this year, but it appears he's going to stay at running back. I know they drafted Jamal Williams from BYU, but Montgomery proving his worth.
And he proved it, yeah, proved it last year. 5.4 yards per carry, 4th best in the league. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice gain.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Still first down.
The penalty on first down backs him up 5. It's now first down at 15. From the gun, it's Rodgers. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down. And now the offensive starters for the Packers.
One thing about talent, it travels in the NFL, and Martellus Bennett, no matter where he plays, no matter what uniform he puts on, he plays at a Pro Bowl level. Strong, fast, smart, able to get down the middle of the field and also work on the perimeter to make big catches and provide an excellent target for his quarterback.
On 2nd down, Montgomery, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on 3rd and long.
count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
And allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Call it a gain of 5, fourth down now.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
At the end of one, 7-0 is our score. We'll return after this message. You're watching the NFL, and it's right here. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Second quarter about to get underway with the Packers in possession of the football. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalposts. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade 6s for 3s, things are going to work out in your favor.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Now Ryan on 2nd down. Looking downfield for Jones. And that's caught inside the 35. A big play there. Ryan to Jones. 43 yards.
Look, it's real simple. Julio Jones is not a one-trick pony by any stretch. But his ability to go up in the air and take the ball away from everyone, forget 50-50s. When it's the moment of truth and someone has to come down with the football, I'm betting Julio Jones usually does.
To Freeman. He'll get about 6 there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. 50, Mike's 50. On 2nd down, Freeman. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
It's Freeman. He'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Now they'll throw it with Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
But Julio Jones is off to a monster first half, but still, can he reach what he did against the Panthers in 2016? Didn't he go for a cool 300 in that game?
On the dot in week four, 300 yards. Oh, Matt Ryan had a pretty good game, too, threw for over 500. On third down, Devontae Freeman. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. They only got two, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it first and goal. Two minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. In just 2 minutes' time, don't forget, we'll get you to Orlando for our halftime report. To bring it to you, who else but Larry Ridley?
Now that man knows his football. Go get him, Larry.
Here's Ryan to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
They'll look to run with Freeman. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It'll be a loss of one, and that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. Third and two, now Ryan. His pass caught at the four. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So on fourth down, off goes Matt Ryan, and on is another Matt Bryant. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. Set to return, this is Jeff Janis. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it, they're down, they're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
That's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
On second down, here's Rodgers. He finds an opening past the 40. Caught on the right side by Adams. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. First down, Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
I know Davante Adams really developed in 2016 as a receiver for Green Bay. I think he had plenty of incentive because when Aaron Rodgers breaks contain, gets out of the pocket, anything can happen downfield. You can find yourself open, can't you?
And it makes Adams a high-volume guy. Week 7 and 8 last year, 25 catches. Highest two-game total in the illustrious history of the Packers.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Now Rodgers. And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So the offensive unit called the TO. And now we are ready to resume play. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. So we are at halftime here in Atlanta with the Falcons out in front. As we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks. And welcome everyone to our EA Sports halftime report. Let's get to the highlights. The Falcons are happy to be sitting in the locker room with a lead. The Packers just want to come out after the half and claw their way back into the game. So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Down to the middle of the first, Jones is wide open down the field. And this great play will go for 6. That takes the lead up to 7. First and 10, Rodgers on point with the throw, and he'll end up at the 35-yard line before being tackled. Packers would later kick the field goal. Now 2nd and 8. It's going to be Ryan to Jones on the deep ball, and he'll end up at the 30-yard line before being tackled. They would go on to kick a field goal and put 3 points on the board. Packers with the ball late in the half. It's Aaron Rodgers hooking up with his big play receiver, Davante Adams, and he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to their own 43-yard line. So that'll bring our halftime report to a close. We'll go back now to Mercedes-Benz Stadium for the start of the third quarter.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is taken at the 3. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Got a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Rodgers now on first down. Got it complete to Rodgers. And he's brought down, but not before a really nice stiff arm to create a little space. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Rodgers hands to Montgomery, and he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
12 yards there as they move the chains.
Have you gotten used to seeing Martellus Bennett, number 80? I mean, he's been number 88 his entire career, right?
And how about that, the fans selecting his jersey number?
Yeah, that was his idea. He put that out there on social media and said, here are a few choices. What should I wear? And he went with what the fans picked. Over 100,000 people weighed in.
Fresh set of downs here. Montgomery back to the ground. And he'll work his way inside the 30 now to the 28. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Keep pounding here with Montgomery. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. Throwing is Rodgers. He's got Adams on the hookup. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Rodgers finding Adams for a Packer first.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you could actually be pushed back before the first down. It's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the first down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
So the offense has it 1st and 10. First down, here's the run to Montgomery. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
Wasn't that long ago that the NFL guys really didn't adopt much from the college game. But one thing that has crept in there is spreading things out, opening things up, not even just in tempo, but maybe getting better line splits and spreading the field. I think that would be a great strategy right now to try to open things up in the run game.
And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments and run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And complete on the right side to Bennett. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 17-yard line.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
So now on 4th down, Rodgers will give way to Mason Crosby for the field goal try. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And Crosby puts it through, and that gets him back within a single point. It's now 10-9. And the attempt at 3 will have to come from the other end of the field as time has run out on this 3rd quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. For the 4th quarter, we'll begin with a kickoff following the Crosby on now to kick it away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
On first and 10, it's Ryan. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one goes for 24 yards.
What may seem a little unorthodox to some people, got the lead fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
Now, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
They run, Devontae Freeman. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
To the offense lining up 1st and 10. And now a 10th carry for Freeman. And he'll get 4 here down to the 35-yard line. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Second down following the run. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
This is 3rd and 2, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Now it's Freeman. So he got 3 of 1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard.
You know, we might start getting some props here in the booth. You know, that one that says the D and then the fence that you put up next to it. How about that? They brought out the jumbo package and still couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage enough to pick up that first down.
Impressive. They were ready defensively for that jumbo set. Devontae Freeman, his shiftiness doesn't pay off here in short yardage. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. Boy, you talk about not playing it safe. Why were they going for it there, Charles?
It's got to be a full evaluation of their team. Do they trust their defense in this situation? Maybe they think they've given all they can in this game and they don't have anything left. Do they not trust that the other team's quarterback is just so hot that it, no matter where they get the ball, they go downfield? Remember when Bill Belichick went for it in that game, right, against Indianapolis on the road, and everybody said, why'd you go for it there? I think he just thought to himself, on the other side, if they hit the ball, they're going downfield anyway. He was trying to end the game right there with his own offense.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys that we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Caught left side, Bennett. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Back to throw. This is Cobb with a catch right side. Touchdown, Packers! Randall Cobb, 57 yards. And the Packers have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. Back to throw, Rodgers. He's got it. And they will not go quietly as we are back to a two-score game. And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
Crosby on now to kick it away. Now Hardy on the return. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And now let's discuss Julio Jones. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. They've got his man complete. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, 76 yards. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game.
Yes, it was a touchdown. And not just a TD, but how about a long touchdown that puts them in a great position now.
And now just an extra point away from tying this thing. And now a critical extra point attempt here. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. And they're able to get the connection on the long touchdown pass, and that's one of the easiest drive summaries you'll ever see. One play, touchdown. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
and they've got to feel comfortable with that. But they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, let's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. He'll leave it for Montgomery complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a second down. Rodgers to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Adams. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. The Packers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. To throw is Rodgers. Throw left side complete. It's Bennett. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. A Packer first, Rodgers to his new target, Bennett. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Now Rodgers. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. The new acquisition, Martellus Bennett, the intended target. That'll bring up second down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers. Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. It gets it over the middle to Cobb. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. Give this one to Montgomery, and they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Again, they'll go ground with Montgomery, and he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave him with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. And his kick here is good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. And I tell you, when it comes to needing a field goal in closing seconds, pressure situation, there's something to be said for having a veteran kicker trot out there.
Agreed. It's so nice to have someone you can rely on, someone who you know has done it before. And this guy's as cool as they come, isn't he?
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Six. We're going into the final play. game. They knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we say so long, everybody.